Good morning, good afternoon, good evening if you're watching on replay, and welcome to my Kundalini Wake Up class. And this is a class for you to be able to bring your mind, your body, your soul, your spirit into awareness. Kundalini yoga is yoga of awareness, and this is, as I say, a wake up class to get you ready, invigorated, and ready to start your day. So in order to do that, I invite you to get yourself an oil. Any oil will do. Your favorite oil is likely to wake you up. This is actually eucalyptus today because I needed some relief from a bit of congestion. So if you're not allergic to oil, you can place it on your throat, you can place it wherever you need it. So this is eucalyptus, which is great for the airways. So the other thing about oils is that oils bring you back into your body. So oils have the ability to bring you back into your body through the sense of smell, obviously, the sense of smell. And we can drop our cortisol, our sympathetic nervous system can be re-ignited into our rest and digest, our parasympathetic, through aromatherapy as well as through the other things that we do, especially in Kundalini yoga, where we move between the systems in the body in order to feel the release. You cannot have one without the other. There is no dark without light. There is no uppers without downers. There is no sympathetic without a parasympathetic. We cannot be in both, in one state all the time. So this invites you today, this invitation today, is for you just to drop into your body, arrive in the space. So each Kundalini class, we begin our Kundalini class with, with a card. Let me just over here and get the cards. We always do a tune-in and a card. So today, I'm going to use Rebecca Campbell's Starseed Oracles. Starseed Oracles. And these invite us into wherever we are at today. So what is the date today? Today is the 18th of July. It's my wedding anniversary. 14 years. So let's do 14. Let's do 14. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, eleven, twelve, thirteen, 14. So what is our guidance for today? To be cracked open, to go to rock bottom, surrender to the alchemy of life. So I love this because, you know, it says being cracked open means that you're cracking yourself open to something new. And we have to go to rock bottom to do that. We have to like reach that point of like really getting to an all-time low in order to crack right open for something else to come through, for the light to shine through in our lives. So I will quickly read you the description in the book as well. Always good to have some guidance with our day. Surrender to the alchemy of life. Surrender to the alchemy of life. Letting things unfold as is. Don't let the weight and density of the world squash your tender spirit. Instead, let it call even more of it home into your body, at the center front of your life. It's through the extreme pressure of life's trials that diamonds are cultivated. It's when things are at their darkest that we can cultivate proper faith and our light is ignited. It's through the crumbling that we can allow our wounds to be alchemized. Let your pains, sorrow and losses make you, not break you. Let life alchemize your tragedies into gold. Be open to being cracked open, wide open. It's the difficult times that help us grow in leaps and bounds, and in ways we could only dream were possible. But first they have to crack us open. Sometimes it hurts like hell. It's nature's way. Whether you let it happen or not, it's going to happen. So surrender to the process. It's how the light gets in. When your heart cracks open, a space is created for your soul to more fully enter. When your soul cracks open, a space is created for the grace of the Holy Spirit to enter. Let your trials, your sorrows, your pains and your losses transform you into more and more of yourself. Stay open to the possibility that your tragedies, your losses, your sorrows and your hurt happened for you, not to you. Bless the thing that broke you down and cracked you open, because the world needs you open. Surrender to the alchemy of life. And the Starseed Soul Inquiry is, how can you let your life crack open? So my invitation now then to you is to open, see what you can crack open through doing this class today. What's coming through for you? And that's what Kundalini does. It really awakens you. It enlivens you. It's, you know, you've heard of the Kundalini awakening, and that's what happens when we practice Kundalini. Our spiritual awakening becomes present. It becomes present. We want to do that slowly. So today we're going to take it slowly. We do our, because this is a beginner's wake up, we will be doing our practice between 1 and 3 minutes. We won't be going into anything much longer than that for each Kriya, for each pose. So just get yourself a nice, you don't have to have a yoga mat, you can have a sheepskin or rug, and a bolster is always handy, maybe a shawl or blanket for Savasana. So let us begin. Let's begin with tuning in. Look at my past videos if you want to know more about Kundalini Yoga and the basis of Kundalini Yoga. But we will be always tuning in, breath work, pumping the breath, fire breath. There's quite a lot to it. So just go back and have a look at past videos, especially the one at the beginning, the first video that I posted with Kundalini, to give you some really good sort of basics. To begin. So let us tune in. Let's sit in an easy pose. So if you're very flexible, you can sit in lotus, but just in an easy pose, cross legs, opening up your spine, sitting up nice and straight. You might want to pull in your mula bandha, your uddiyana bandha, the anal passage, the sex organs, and in at the belly button. Place your hands in prayer position. And if we're tuning in, you might also want to look up into the third eye. And you may also want to have a very sort of first stage Jalandabandha, which is just the throat. So instead of pushing all the way down, just a little bit in the throat, okay? So sitting up nice and tall, keeping the air in your body, keeping the energy locked in your body through the locks. But the most important thing is just to tune in. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. You're tuning in with the seed mantra, Adi mantra, and then a Mangalacharan mantra, protection mantra. Join in where you can. Thank you. Through your energy channel and out through your perineum. So we're ready to begin our class today. So we're going to start with Sufi grind. So we're just rolling around. We can go, I find it more comfortable on my knees. If you find it more comfortable on cross-legged, then stay in cross-legged. But you're just moving around in circles. So breathing in and then breathing out. You can let out of your mouth. Breathing in and round. So you can go all the way around one way and then the other, or you can take turns which way you go. Okay? And that's all you need to do. And you're doing that for around 3 minutes, but just take your time, keep breathing, keep noticing and witnessing where is the air going into your body, where do you need to loosen some more, where is tight, as my knees, crack.
Thank you.
suspend your breath. Take a deep breath in, suspend your breath. And then sigh it out. So the more that you allow yourself the time to get into each pose, the more the awakening starts to happen in the body. So now we're just going to be practicing some very simple neck rolls. So you're going to literally be going around in circles. So go around in circles, breathing in through your nose. And change direction when you feel maybe you're getting a bit dizzy. See how it feels in your body. Just keep remembering to breathe. It's really important. The breath is everything. Going, even when I stop, you keep going because I'm looking at lots of different things. We hold so much tension in the spine. When we sleep, it compresses. When we wake up, we want to decompress the spine, opening up the spine, allowing in the air, the breath, the chi, the prana, the life force energy. So come in a moment to center. To come to the center, take a deep breath in. You can sigh it out or breathe it back down through your body, whatever your breath needs right now. Listen to your own body. So now we are going to continue with the upper body spinal stretching through the shoulders. We get so much tension in the shoulders. This is where we hold so much tension. So my nose is a little bit, I didn't use the neti pot this morning and usually use it every morning and totally forgot. So neti pot, really important, clear the nostrils each morning so you can breathe through both nostrils, but breathing in and out. Okay, in and out, in and out, shrugs. Makes a big difference. Oh. makes a big difference using a neti pot. A big difference. So when it's not used, then we often still hold congestion in our noses. So highly recommend that you do this, that you have a neti pot before each pass. Just being honest, didn't get a chance or totally forgot. Let us begin shrugging our shoulders. So breathing in and out. Start to feel your neck crack and click. You can go slowly. Breathing in to the left, out to the right. If you want to do both shoulders, remember you can stop in between. You are always able to rest. If you find things too much, just stop, just breathe normally. I'll take some deep breaths. If it's too strong for you, just keep stopping. You can always do both shoulders and drop as well. Finding that really strong myself this morning. Bring your head down, release your spine if it's starting to hurt, and then go back in. If you close your eyes, you're not distracted, it's usually very helpful. Relax and drop it out if it's too much for you right now. And then come back in. Keep going if you can. Nearly there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take a deep breath in. Shrug your shoulders. And then just drop it out when you are ready. Okay. That's a hard one when you've got tight shoulders, right? So now, spinal flexes. So again, you can stay on a bolster, you can cross your legs, whatever is most comfortable for you. But you're going to push your chest forward to breathe in. And flex back to breathe out, okay? Bring in, breathe in and out, okay? In and out. So we're keeping our head kind of at level. It's not a cat-cow where you're looking up and down. It's a forward and back, forward and back. Breathing back down strongly through the body. Spinal flexes. 3 minutes, spinal flexes. really good for your spine, spinal fluid, getting it all moving. Think about where the Kundalini energy comes from, your spine, that uncoiling that Kundalini snake, activating your Kundalini awakening, bringing it up from your roots, from your sacral chakra, giving rise. Pull up your Mulabandha when you're doing this as well. You can hold in both your root locks on the out breath. So try practicing if you can the Mulabandha, the Uddiyana Bandha. In the spinal flex, when you're breathing in. Keep going. Keep breathing in and out. Breath in, suspend your breath. Sigh it out when you are ready. All right, cat cow. So, there are various ways to practice cat cow on your tabletop. So, you know, the basic way to practice cat cow, looking up, bending your spine, sticking out to your bottom, flexing your spine fully, and then into cat, really arching your back, and really bringing the air back down through your body, like a cat on a hot tin roof. So when a cat drops, it drops in this very arched position. So, you can either just do slow, gentle breathing in, breathing out, back down through your body, breathing in, back down. If you're more advanced and you have a very flexible spine, you can pump. If it wasn't so congested, right? Okay, you're gonna pump your body. Okay, do it nice and clear, great. Can you hear that breath? So if you are capable, even try pumping sort of intermittently. If you can't do the whole 3 minutes, maybe try like for a minute or 30 seconds, just seeing what it feels like to pump.
This is good.
5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take a deep breath in. Suspend your breath. And then take a deep breath in up. Find it all the way back down through your body. Come into a child's pose from here. Just stretching out your arms. Stretching out your arms in an active, to start with, in an active child's pose. So bring your forehead to the floor. Stretch your arms out, open your legs wide. Let your body fall between your legs. This is where you really make it relaxing. So you stretch your arms out, forehead on the floor, and then just let your arms just fall back. And just breathe into your nose and back down through your body, or out through your mouth. Ah, relax. And this is just a restful child's pose. Just keep breathing. Allowing your body to relax. Your hips to stretch. Feel free to like use the music as well to have a gentle move in. If your hips are feeling tight and you can really feel them, just work your body in. Remember, you're always like, nothing is like set solid. Everything is movable. Everything is flexible. Everything is not set a certain way. We can move, listen to our bodies in each pose. Let your thoughts come in, let them come out. Let them pass like clouds in the sky. Just allowing your body to open up. The hip openers is where the magic happens. If you feel comfortable, you can put your forehead on your hands, whatever you need. In this moment, and as you sit in this moment, know that your body is taking care of you. The universe has your back. The air you're breathing into your hips is opening you up just a little bit more, physically, emotionally, spiritually. When we open our legs, we are saying yes to life. yes to the Shakti energy, the Kundalini, divine feminine energy that we are cultivating in our bodies through this practice. Such a necessary and beautiful allowance. Take a deep breath in. Sigh it out or breathe it back down to your body. Take another deep breath in. Suspend your breath. And breathe it back down. Okay, let us move into a cobra. So a cobra, you can do a low cobra. So your hands are on the floor, your lower arms are on the floor, and you're just bending your back slightly. If you're someone like me who has hip and back, lower back issues, then you can adjust, you can come back down, place your head to the side for release, and then just go back up kind of when you're ready. Okay, so this is kind of a cross between Sphinx, Cobra. So, let's do this. Kind of more of a Sphinx. So just looking up, taking a deep breath in, and breathing the air back down through your body, feeling that lower spine. And is it kind of just noticed? Does it need a little bit more breath? You might be able to go up a little bit higher. Today I couldn't possibly, so if you're in Sphinx and you can go up to Cobra, then good. If you're very flexible, today there's no way that I can do that. So I'm gonna listen to my body and stay like this and then come down to rest and go back up. So you listen to what your body needs today. Much for your back, come down. Take your head and your hand to the side. Taking those deep breaths into your diaphragm. Out, release some more. snake it through your hips. Snake the energy down through the body. And look the other side around the other temple. Spend your breath. Move it back down through your body. Okay, and then come up slowly. Come up slowly to your mat. Now we're going to move into an active life nerve stretch. So you're going to place your feet out in front of you. You're going to sit up nice and straight, and you're hinging from the hips. So as always, that's where I can reach before I've got any breath in my body. Okay? So my toes are facing up, and I can't actually reach my toes. But when I breathe in, breathing all the air into my body, the prana, the chi, and I lean forward, I can touch my toes. So we're going to do an active breathing in to rise up and breathe back down through your nose, through your body to stretch to your feet. Okay? Take your time. If you can't do straight legs, then bend your knees, sort of grab your big toes and then just sort of wiggle your way down. You can wiggle your way down. You can hold your hands to your calves. You don't have to reach your toes, even your knees. But the thing is you want to have a nice straight back. And you're hinging from your hips. You're not sort of doing that. You're not collapsing the lower back and reaching out like this. Yeah, that's not what you want to do. You want to be coming up and over. Okay? Up and over. into your spine is life force energy, healing energy. Let's now go back onto our mat, into easy pose. Yes, to easy pose. We do radiance charger. So this is where we're going to pump. So sitting in easy pose if you can, sitting up nice and straight again, and we're going to be can't remember the name, with our thumbs out and our palms, the rest of our fingers in, about 90 degrees, and we're going to be breathing in. Remember to push your tummy out, your diaphragm out, and then you're going to be pumping your tummy. Okay, really energizing your body, really energizing your body. Okay, so thumbs out, fingers in, and 90 degrees. Okay, 90 degrees, I think it's 60 degrees. All right. Down, just sweep your auric field, place your hands down, and then go back up again. Remember, you're working on all the body's systems, so good for your lymphatics and your circuitry and your nervous system. One more minute. Suspend your breath and then sweep your auric field. And you can sigh it out. One of my favorite poses, one of my favorite kriyas. Okay, so moving now into mantra, moving now into using our throat. So we're going to be using our hands for the mudras, and we're going to be saying the words. So the mudras, the hands, the fingers, they have different meanings. They have different planets. So this is Venus and Mars, your thumbs, okay? And then you have Jupiter, Saturn, the Sun, and Mercury. And they all have different expressions, okay? So we have knowledge, patience, vitality, and communication. And they have different names as well. So we have Gyan Mudra, Shuni Mudra, Surya Mudra, and Bodhi Mudra. Okay, and we may put them all together. Sa-ta-na-ma, 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 Sa-ta-na-ma. Beginning, life, death, rebirth. Beginning, life, death, rebirth. Sa-ta-na-ma. Okay? And so this is something which is amazing for brain fog. It's amazing, apparently, for people with Alzheimer's. Anything where the brain is starting to shut down, because it keeps you focused. It's a bit like, it's kind of like a stim, isn't it? It's kind of a stim that, I've seen people with learning disabilities use this, or autism, as a stim, as a way to regulate the body, as a natural way of regulating that comes naturally to some people. So you can do it actively. You can lean your hands on your knees. I've seen it done. Sa-ta-na-ma, 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 sa-ta-na-ma. Whatever feels, just starting off like this will give you. So also being aware of those locks. Remember, when you're sitting in seated position, always being aware of the locks from Mula Bandha, the Uddiyana Bandhas, keeping in that nice straight spine if you can. Okay. Excuse me with the congestion today. Use the neti pot every day. Note to self. Makes a big difference. Big difference using a neti pot, I can tell you. Let's do this. So we actually did 4 minutes without blinking there. Okay, now moving into our third eye awakening, into opening up our third eye. Apologies, shuffling. Shuffle, shuffle, keep on shuffling. All right, there we are through. So yes, let's go into our third eye and into our awakening. So let's start off looking up into our third eye. Looking up, but let's start actually pulling up those root knots, keeping them there, keeping the chest open, the heart open, the air coming in and out of the body, okay? Then looking up into the third eye, into the light between your eyes, into the violet flame, sitting up nice and straight. Bringing your hands into prayer position, bringing all those planets together into existence, putting your thumbs on your thymus, into your immunity, sitting up nice and straight. And just keep breathing back down through your body. Mantra, meditation, savasana, all important parts of your day, your practice. Your enlightenment on every day, each day. Bring in the Jalandhavanda in the throat, the light one where you still look up into your third eye.
Thank you.
Suspend your breath. Hold your breath. And then breathe it back down through your body. And out of your perineum. So now moving into your crown chakra, into your savasana. Let us move into a savasana now. So actually just make the Venus mudra and then push it out, sending love out to the world. Make a Jupiter mudra, which is the Jupiter fingers and all the other fingers are crossed. Take a deep breath in and set your Jupiter to the north node, to expansion, as we move into changing north node right now in the astrology, just after the new moon. At the same time, we are moving into a Venus expansion in Leo, which is exactly where the astrology is right now, coming into Leo. So just calling in that expansion and then sweep your arms around your auric field and come into a savasana, lying on your back. Lying on your back. So, place your feet on the ground. I always suggest lifting up your back into a slight bridge, pushing your bottom towards your feet, gets your back right on the ground. You can place a bolster underneath your knees if you wish. Palms facing up. Allow your body to go into deep breath. If your back is not comfortable, then just bring your knees up to your chest and just kind of wriggle your spine onto the floor. Okay? You might want to have a little happy baby and then go back down, stretching your legs out into a savasana. Okay? This is where you just let your body relax and just surrender. Just surrender. Thank you. knees up to your chest. Give yourself a big hug. Well done for showing up today. Give yourself that big hug of thanks to yourself. And then separate your legs into a happy baby. And then a high happy baby. You can rock up or roll onto your side, whatever feels most comfortable to you. Place your hands on your body, take a deep breath in and sigh it out. And again, when you're ready, take a deep breath in and sigh it out. And one more time, a deep breath in, sigh it out. And we close this class and every class with Sat Nam. Have a beautiful day.